Xcode 15 beta is here. Today we are going to explore the newest advancements in productivity and performance found in Xcode 15. Let's uncover the enhancements to code completion and Xcode previews, gain insights into the bookmarks navigator, and delve into the streamlined source control process. We have a lot to cover, so let's dive deep and find out what's new in Xcode 15 beta. And if you want to find out even more about Xcode 15 awesome features, go ahead and check out SWIFTUI Nation, my community. You can join at store.rebeloper.com/community. And today we are going to talk about what's new in Xcode 15 beta. So you want to download Xcode 15 beta, check out the video that I made previously. It should be somewhere over here also. Let me just open it up. So let's double click on here and let's create a new project. Let me resize this and make sure that you select iOS and app, and let's click on next right over here. And under product name, my first one. Okay, new thing here, under storage, you can select Swift data, core data, or of course none. We are going to select none for now, but make sure you subscribe to the channel because we are going to dive deep into Swift data. I'm going to have a series on this soon. So let's click on next right over here. Let's drop it somewhere and make sure that you select source control, create Git repository on my Mac, because we are going to have some new stuff over there too. Okay, so as you can see, it looks exactly the same. So let's dive deep into the new stuff. First is, well, basically my very favorite one is the quick actions. So if you hit Command Shift A, the quick actions bar will pop up, and then you can just search anything and just go maybe content view, whatever you'd like, and you can search for it and you can just simply jump to line. It's so super fun to use. Okay, that's quick actions. Next up, and this is really new, the bookmarks navigator. You see, we have something new right over here, and you can bookmark certain parts of your code. Of course, we previously had something like to-dos, but now it's gotten even better. So let's just, you could just either tap on this ellipsis button and then just bookmark a line or a file. But let's just see, I'm going to bookmark the content view struct. So right click on it, and we could just bookmark the whole content view.swift or the content view Swift line 10. So I will just do that. And as you can see, now I have a new bookmark right over here. I'm also going to bookmark maybe the text. It doesn't really matter for the sake of this tutorial. But now you can see that we have two bookmarks right over here. I'm going to remove the canvas for now. As you can see here, we have our bookmarks. You can click right over here, double click on it, and you could just edit the description. And let's just see view, and you will see that here is our view, and then right click on it again, edit the description, and you can let's say a text or whatever you see that's a good fit for your bookmark name. Now you can also use this as a kind of a to-do list where you can just check the one that you have completed. Or you could just simply delete the bookmark altogether, and then, you know, you don't have anything there. Now, let me just add that bookmark in again. So what you can also do is just select all of them, and then you can just create a new group from selection and just name it, I don't know, to-dos. But most probably you are going to name this much more appropriately according to whatever these bookmarks may mean to you. So these bookmarks are really, really fun to use. I highly recommend them. Are you a SwiftUI developer looking to stay ahead of the curve and master the latest advancements in this cutting-edge framework? Look no further than SwiftUI Nation, the ultimate community for SwiftUI enthusiasts like you. Join us in our weekly Zoom events where we dive deep into SwiftUI's latest features, share insider tips and tricks, and foster a collaborative environment for knowledge exchange among talented developers. Don't miss out on the opportunity to enhance your SwiftUI skills and connect with like-minded professionals. Join SwiftUI Nation today at store.rebeloper.com/community and unlock your true potential in the world of SwiftUI development. Next up is Bookmarks inside Search. So let's just go into the search and let's just search for the content, maybe just for the content. And here we go. We have our searches for the content. If we right click on it, you can bookmark this find content. So we can just do that, add it to bookmarks. And now you see right over here, we have a content search. And if you are going to update that search or any other bookmark, you can just click on the refresh right over there and it will just refresh the bookmark for you. Of course, you can just move this search into maybe a searches group, or, you know, it's relatively simple to gather all of your bookmarks into these groups. Okay, so next up is something new in the Swift language, and Xcode goes with it. It's Swift macros. And here it is. It's hash preview. Let's just put back the canvas right over here. And as you can see, here we have our preview of our content view. Now, if we add another one, let's just copy and paste that. We have another preview, as you can see. Two previews side by side. Also, you can add a second name to your preview, which is really, really a welcomed addition. Those are previews, and there are a lot to talk about macros. Go ahead and subscribe again to the channel because I'm going to release videos on these new topics also. Next up is the documentation preview. So let's say we added a documentation right over here, option command forward slash, and we are going to have the view that is starting the app with. Okay, so okay, this is a good documentation and you're just writing that, but what if, and let me just go right over here to the app file, and if I option click on it, now you can see that we have the view that is starting the app with. Okay, this is fine, but when I wrote that out, it wasn't that intuitive. Now, Xcode supports live editing, so here it is. So under content view, you want to select assistant, and then go and select download preview, and here it is. Now you can add your whatever. Let's see, this is so cool. Okay, and you can have this documentation preview, so you might as well write better documentation with it. Okay, next up is code completion. Now, first I want to check out is the assets catalog. Let's create a new color right over here. So let's create a new color set. I will name this my color. And I would just leave it as is, it doesn't really matter. Now inside the content view, and let's just go back, and I will remove the assistant for now, so we may have a much larger space right over here. Next up is code completion, and we are going to start off with the assets catalog. I have created here a deep white color. So right over here on the content view, I can access it without the string value. So this will be really cool. Color, and just go dot and start typing it out, deep white. It's super, super fun. Also, please note that let's just create a new color set, and let's just say this will be my color. That is the name. Now, under the content view, if you want to access that color and type my, As you can see, it's just the my color, but it says the my color asset catalog color resource. So color will be deducted from that. So it will just say my. So make sure that you name your colors appropriately as you wish. This is also a good feature to have. Okay, so another code completion improvement. Let's just have a new file right over here. It will be a Swift file, and I will name this my text field. Okay, let's create that, and I will just import SwiftUI right over here, and I will create a struct of my text field. So if I type out M, it will suggest that this should be my text field because the file name is my text field. Okay, and I'm just going to leave it as if that is, because that is the awesomeness of the code completion that I wanted to show you. Okay, next up is creating view modifiers. So right over here under the text, we just add a dot. And as you can see, it is suggesting the font and then the bold. Now, under the font there, here you can see that we have an arrow right over here. And then you can just have those multiple variations. Now, under font, we don't have much. But if we just go under, let's just go VStack and padding, and just hit dot, and then padding and hit the right arrow, you will see that we have these options available. So yeah, I'm just go with the simple one for now. For the color, let's just have a frame. And you see we have quite a lot right over here. So I will just have the right arrow, and then I will just have maybe a height of 100. That's perfectly fine. Now, you saw that when I was jumping through all of these specific views and added view modifiers, the more used ones were suggested to me. So for example, under the text, if I just hit dot right over here, the font will be the top suggested one, and that next up comes bold. So let's just go the font of title. That's perfectly fine. Now under the V stack, the padding will be shown. Okay. And if we added already the first suggested one, in our case, this is the font. If I hit dot again, you can see now foreground strand will be there. And it's all according to your coding style. You can just select bold right over here, whatever you'd like. Okay, so next up is source control navigator. So under the source control navigator, as you can see, we added quite some changes, and they are not stashed right over here. Unstate change, it says. So if we click on it, then you can stage the change. Now it's filled with blue, and then you can just go under source control, and you see all of your files. This is under changes. It's much, much simpler. So you can see we have stage changes, some changes staged, and some changes did not stage, and also we added and modified all of that stuff. This is really, really cool. So what we can do is go under integrate and then commit. So the new commit dialog, well, the new commit window will just pop up, and you can just take a look at these new commits. Really, really cool. We have a lot of commits under the project file, but as you can see, we have our contents JSON file. Let's just scroll a little bit down so we can see a little bit of code. And as you can see, these are committed, these are not committed. These, and you can just click and stage the change right over here. Also stage the change. It's really, really nice. One thing that you could also do is, let me just scroll a little bit up right over there. You can actually make sure that this is a smaller version, like it's compact, or it is expanded all the way through the code. Now you can just add a commit message, my first message right over here, and then just click commit, and it will be committed. Now, if you want to push to the GitHub repository, then you want to first create one. So let's create a new remote right over there. It will be public, that's fine. Let's create that. pushing. And now if we go back to changes and you can stage all, yeah, let's just do that. And now you can just unstage the changes, discard the changes. Let's go under repositories, staged, and go under integrate and push everything up. There we go, pushing it up. It's a much more streamlined way of handling your source control. Now, if you want to get all of these goodies, you must download Xcode 15 beta. Go ahead and check out how to do that. The video is right over here.